Voice chat represents a massive barrier to the inclusion of deaf and hard of hearing people in multiplayer games. I personally can't imagine playing any game with friends without using Discord to talk during the game. Voice chat allows us to coordinate our actions with our teammates, allows us to talk with people while doing other things, and is generally an extremely useful tool. As someone who only had virtual friends for a long time, I can tell you that voice chat can be a very important part of a gamer's social life. People with hearing impairment aren't exactly unfit to use voice chat. Most of them can still speak, furthermore, most of them can hear to some extent, and there's really no reason why they should be limited from being able to play games with it. Modern automatic speech recognition systems are extremely proficient at understanding all sorts of speech. The use of machine learning allows them to adapt to any accent and improve their vocabulary indefinitely. My favorite example of how this works is this video of a Russian research scientist at Google who learned English after becoming deaf, so he has a very unique accent that is difficult to understand. He relies on Live Transcribe, a free ASR app for Android, which he personally trained for his own needs using recordings of his speech to effectively communicate with other people on a daily basis. Some popular multiplayer games already provide voice chat transcriptions, particularly games made with Microsoft's PlayFab, which is an API that brings multiplayer to over 5,000 games. PlayFab allows developers to integrate both speech-to-text and text-to-speech at no extra cost to them, and yet, not many seem to bother. Some of the only games that provide ASR voice chat transcriptions include Sea of Thieves, Forza Horizon 4, and Halo Wars 2. For my final year project at university, I wanted to explore why this accessibility feature is so underutilized in games. Having to rely on the accessibility features provided in the game can be limiting, so my idea was to create a universal app that could be used along with most games. The app is named Discord CC and it uses a Discord bot to transcribe speech in a voice chat with the deep speech algorithm and then output it on the user's screen. Discord CC is made of two parts, the server-side program, which is just the Discord bot, and a client-side app, which visualizes the transcriptions on its user's screen. Discord CC works similarly to a typical messenger, as the bot sends out messages with transcriptions to each DCC user using WebSockets. The transcriptions are shown as an overlay over any other active program, similar to how the heads-up display is shown in games. Here I wanted to make something that would not obstruct your vision in a game and at the same time make it easy to spot new messages. For this purpose, I decided to step away from the usual transcription design that can be found in the games I previously talked about and rather adopt a design that is typical to messenger apps. I had carried out multiple tests in different games with people of different backgrounds to see how well the app performs, testing both the usability of this approach to accessibility and the accuracy of the transcriptions. The app has proven to be very useful in fast-paced games where the players communicate using short phrases, so the audio was quickly transcribed and was shown on the user screen within a couple of seconds. I have encountered some difficulties in games like Among Us where players were having long conversations and so the transcription could not keep up with them. The app also generally struggled to understand various accents due to the algorithm's language model being trained to understand mostly American dialects. I would really love to hear what you think of this project. I personally think that this accessibility method has a future and I'm excited to carry on expanding it. However, there are things that I may not be able to accomplish alone. For instance, I'm currently relying on a language model that comes with deep speech as I don't possess the hardware for training a custom model. You are welcome to adapt the code for use in your own projects or fork the repository and help me make voice chat communication more inclusive. You are watching Ilya, my name is Ilya, and I'll see you here again soon.